scripture says, it's there in verse 38, the scripture says that Jesus was in the stern of the ship, sleeping. He's sleeping on the pillow of promises. He's sleeping on the pillow of promises. And the disciples woke him up. They woke Jesus up while he's sleeping, while he's just getting his rest. And they wake him up and they ask him a question. Master, don't you care? Aren't you concerned? Don't you have a little compassion? We in a storm. Water in the ship. It's about to take over the ship. We're not ready to drown. I can't get this. And Jesus looked at them. And he gets up and he goes out and he says, peace be still. And the winds lay down and the waves behave themselves and the thunder stopped frightening them and the lightning stopped flashing. Everything was calm. Complete. There's nobody in this room. Conference of this sanctuary, this church, this building, that has never been in a panic situation. Notice that when you're in a panic situation, when your dilemma calls you to panic, when your situation calls you to panic, when your circumstances calls you to panic, always remember that Jesus is in the heart of Saul. I said Jesus is in the center of your soul. The Bible says right here that he's in the stern of the ship. Anybody know that's the center? That's the heart of the ship. Can I get a witness in here? And if you got Jesus in the center, if you got Jesus in the stern, if you got Jesus in the heart, you can ride out your soul. They move with Jesus up. Man, don't you just win a song? We not ready to perish. We not ready to be destroyed. We are not ready to be doomed. And Jesus calmly get up. And he says three words. Peace be still. When you're in the panic mode, it may be because of your direction. When we're in a panic mode, it might be because of your destination. Notice what Jesus says in verse 35. It was evening time. Him and his disciples were there on the shore. And Jesus said to them, let us go over to the other side. Jesus was giving them direction. Have I got a witness? But they went to listen. They didn't hear what Jesus was saying. Jesus said, let us go over to the other side. Now he didn't tell them that they were going to have to experience sometimes. Let me just talk about it. Before they get over to the other side. He gave them directions and he even gave them their destination. Ain't nobody. At the same time, he the divine design, their direction, and their destination. Can I get a witness here? You hear what I said? I said the divine designed not only their direction, but their destination. And what I'm trying to tell you, sometimes when you're going through some stuff, remember the divine has already designed your direction and your destination. Whatever you're going through, you better make sure that the divine designed it. Just somebody high five and say, I don't mind going through it now. Just somebody high ten and say, I'm gonna ride it out because of the fire that already decided my direction and my destination. He said, let us go over to the other side. In the middle, traveling to the other side, they encounter some death. In the midst of that, they encounter some fire. In the midst of that, they encounter some trouble. In the midst of that, they experience some tragedy. In the midst of that, but they were trying.